Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 102 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 175 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 176 and question 177. Further we will talk about question number 166 as well. Question 176. You have an Azure subscription that contains a web app named WebApp1. You need to add a custom domain named www.contoso.com to WebApp1. What should you do first? Let's go to learn.microsoft.com. We are on map an existing custom DNS name to Azure App Service page in learn.microsoft.com. There are three steps to add a custom domain. Configure a custom domain, create the DNS record, validate and complete. We'll scroll down. The DNS record types you need to add with your domain provider depends on the domain you want to add to app service. If it is root domain, we require A record. If it is subdomain, we require CNAME record. And if it is wildcard, then CNAME record. These are the prerequisites to add custom domain. Step 1, we'll configure a custom domain in Azure portal. In web app, we'll go to custom domains and add a custom domain. We'll fill up the domain provider detail. We'll write down the domain information and we will validate the domain ownership. Step 2, we'll create the DNS records. So we will go to domain provider site and we will add the DNS record depending on the domain type. If it is root domain, we'll create two records, A record and TXT record. If it is subdomain and we go with the A record, we'll have A record and text record. If we go with the CNAME record, we'll have CNAME and text record. And if it is wildcard, create two records according to following table, CNAME and TXT. Finally, we will validate the ownership of domain and complete. Let's go back to question. Stopping web app will not help in adding the custom domain. Option C, upload a certificate. It is related to installing SSL. Therefore, it is not about adding a custom domain. Option B, add a connection string. Adding a connection string is for connecting with database. Option A, create a DNS record is the correct answer. Question 177. You have an Azure subscription that contains the resources shown in the following table. RG1 is a resource group located in West US. RG2 is a resource group located in East Asia. Storage 1 is storage account located in West US. Storage 2 is storage account located in East Asia. VM1 is a virtual machine located in West US. VNet1 is a virtual network located in West US and VNet2 virtual network located in East Asia. VM1 connects to VNet1. So virtual machine 1 connect to VNet1. You need to connect VM1 to VNet2. Now we need to connect VM1 to VNet2. Four versions of this question are available over the internet. Version 1 suggests the solution. You move VM1 to RG2 and then you add new network interface to VM1. Version 2 suggests the solution. You delete virtual machine 1. You recreate virtual machine 1 and then you create new network interface for virtual machine 1 and connect to VNet2. Third solution, you create a new network interface and then you add the network interface to VM1. Fourth solution, you turn off the VM1 and then you add a new network interface to VM1. The question will appear in exam with one of above solution and we will have to select yes or no as answer. Let's go to a blog site to to understand it better. We are in 4sysops.com site and on move an Azure VM to another virtual network page. The article is written by Timothy Warner. He's a Microsoft MVP. Migrate an Azure VM between VNets. The first thing to accept is that Microsoft doesn't support VNet to VNet VM migration, and you will have to redeploy the VM regardless. There are three steps to achieve this. Stop and deallocate virtual machine. Delete the virtual machine but save its virtual hard disk. Recreate the virtual machine in the target VNet by specifying the original disk. Let's move back to question. Therefore, if this question appears with the solution 1, you move VM1 to RG2 and then you add a new network interface to VM will not solve the problem. So answer would be no in first case. If this question appears with the solution 2, you delete VM1, you recreate VM1 and then you create a new network interface for VM1 and connect it to VNet 2. Yes would be the correct answer for option 2. For solution 3, you create a new network interface and then you add the network interface to VM1. Answer would be no. And for solution 4, you turn off VM1 and then you add new network interface to VM1. Answer would be no only. Further, previously we have attended the similar question where we needed to move the custom application from VNet 1 to VNet 2. And the answer were, first you delete the virtual machine and keep the hard drive and create new virtual machine and connect to VNet 2. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.